Born into a background of injustice and division, John Hume was a decisive leader of the civil rights movement in Northern Ireland in 1968.
First, he was real. And secondly, he didn't seem to have an agenda other than the one he was pursuing. He wanted an inclusive peace. And he thought that nonviolence was the best way to pursue it. He was the Irish conflict's Martin Luther King.
John Hume resolutely pursued a peaceful path throughout the Northern Irish conflict.
Before we even got there, he opened fire.
This is the story of how John Hume harnessed the political influence of the Irish-American diaspora to address that legacy of division and to achieve peace.
I think he understood language to be part of the problem. The ability to speak the language of the American politic better than them is a plus.
Tip took his lead of what John was saying. I would say in those days, Tip was taking far more from John than he was from the Irish government, quite frankly.
The State Department was not in favor of what I did, as you may know. But I didn't really consult with them too thoroughly.
There was some broken china there. There were, you know, I had a lot of trouble with the British for a brief period, but I trusted Hume's instincts.
But then you had the American influence, which was a very strange thing for British politics.
It wasn't just the risk of alienating the British. It was also the risk that I would stick my neck out and IRA violence would continue and I would look like I'd been played for a fool.
Now, I am standing here and telling the government that I believe that we have a real process of lasting peace and a total cessation of violence. Hurry up and deal with it.
He grabbed me by the wrists and held my hands and said, look, you can do it, you're near it.
In 1998, the Good Friday Agreement was signed and roundly endorsed in referenda on both sides of the Irish border, and the Northern Irish Troubles ended. Hume's strategy had become a political reality.